Hey programmers, last time we looked at recipes with presets, so today we're going to look at putting recipes in our programmer and in our queues. The recipe lines themselves will look the same as they did within presets, so some of this should feel pretty familiar. Let's start by looking at one of the recipe presets we created last week. If I edit this preset and load it into my programmer, I can see the data on my attributes, but if I look at the programmer parts window, I can also see the same recipe line that I built into this preset. And if we want to make a change to the recipe here in the programmer part, we can. In fact, if you want to start a new recipe preset here in the programmer instead of going into edit options on an empty preset, go for it. I'm adding a group and a preset and a matrix here in the programmer parts, and then I'm going to store this into my preset pool. And when I go into edit options, I can confirm that my recipe was indeed stored. What I'm trying to get at here is that working with recipe lines in the programmer parts or in the edit options in the preset are linked. They're basically the same thing. And I want you to keep that idea in mind when working with queues, because the same thing is true. If I add a recipe in my programmer parts window and store this as a queue, I'll have a recipe reference in the queue. Let me show you what that's going to look like. I'm building a super simple recipe here in the programmer parts window, and then I'm going to store this look to a queue in a new sequence. This could be one line or multiple lines. I could also have other non-recipe data in the programmer at the same time that I could store into the same queue, you know, the way we're used to. So I'm storing this data, clearing out, and playing it back. If I look at my fixture sheet, I can see all the values I expect on my fixtures. It's not immediately obvious, though, that there was a recipe in play, but if I edit Q1 and load it into the programmer, I can see that recipe in my programmer parts window. Let me escape and clear this out so that I can show you another way to load this data. If I type edit option Q1 part 0, please, that will load the recipes into their own window. And these are all great options, but there's an even easier way to see what recipes are stored in your queues, and that's in our sequence sheet. First off, I know that Q1 has a recipe in it because it has the little pot icon, but I want to see more, so I'm going into the window options, and under mask, I want to turn on show recipes. That will give us a section in the lower half of the window where we can see the recipe lines stored in our queues, and it will update based on which queue you are playing or by which queue you select in the sheet. Can we make changes on this line and update our queue? Sure. If I change the preset used to a different preset of the same type, I can see the change is immediate, no cook required. This time, let's go in and pick a different attribute type to change this to, like maybe color instead. Okay, my color is applied and my old position is erased from the queue. Still didn't have to cook. For this third change, I'm going to pick a dimmer preset for my recipe of closed. It's in there, but in the fixture sheet, my lights are still at full. That's because when I originally stored this queue, the dimmer wasn't part of the recipe, so we're currently holding onto the original data. If I want to override the dimmer value with the dimmer information in the recipe, I'm going to have to cook. So I'm typing cook Q1, please. And before I cover the pop-up, I want to let you know that you could also use a syntax like cook sequence number in case you want to cook all recipes in the entire sequence. I could have used that syntax in this example here as well because I only have one recipe in one queue, and I would have gotten this same pop-up. Now, in this case of cooking, merge is not going to do anything for us. The reason is because the original data on intensity did not come from a recipe. Therefore, there's nothing to merge. So, if I want this new recipe data to overtake the information I have on dimmer, I need to choose overwrite. And there it is. This cooking also means that if you had changed what one of the lights in this recipe was doing in this queue to something outside of the recipe, you can always change your mind and go back and recook to put that light back into the recipe look. In those examples, we were tweaking the recipe directly in the sequence sheet. Since we know that these recipes can also show up in the programmer parts window, I also have the option to edit Q1 and then change the recipe in the programmer parts. After I do that, I just hit update and we're there. Same rules apply about cooking, so if you change something that needs to be cooked again, you'll need to do that after the update. I mentioned in the last video that if our intention with recipes was to be able to change the group reference in the recipe, that I didn't recommend doing that with preset recipes. We saw that when we changed the group in the recipe preset, It breaks the preset reference, so any queue that used that recipe was left with hard data on the original fixtures from the recipe, the same way changing the fixtures of any other selective preset would break the reference. And that is no bueno. But here, it's going to work a little differently. I'm going to store a blank Q2 and add a recipe to it right here in the sequence sheet. Remember, these recipe lines work the same whether you're in the sequence sheet, or in a preset, or in the programmer parts window. Okay, that's it. I play back the queue, and there's my look. But now I'm going to change the group here on this line. And I see the little progress bar telling me the console is auto-cooking, and now I can see that this value was applied to the new set of lights. So what happened to this attribute on my original group selection? It's been erased. It's not leaving old hard values, it's just erased it and applied that value to this new group of fixtures. So this recipe line is allowing me to make what I consider an embedded group reference. I might use this functionality in a queue list when I'm in a situation where I don't yet know exactly which group of lights might be used to create a particular look. Or if you're controlling multiple stages and need to change where a look is happening. It could be very interesting, but as always, you're going to need to stay very organized when using this. Now, how about if I change the contents of the group that I used in my recipe by changing what fixtures are stored in the actual group? I'm going to select the first fixture from this group and do a store remove to take him out of that group. Just to check that it's done, I'm selecting the group and yep, we're down fixture 1. Right now, if I look in the fixture sheet, that unit that I removed from the group is still part of the recipe. So I need to cook this queue and I'll pick merge. And now the recipe data for fixture 1 is erased. And it's the same process whether you're removing or adding fixtures to the group in the groups pool. Since I can update just the contents of the group and then recook the sequence, I think this is going to be the method that I'd use in that example I mentioned earlier about times when I'm not sure which lights will be used in certain looks throughout the sequence. Instead of having to go through all the queues and update every different recipe with a new group selection, I'll just create a group specific to this event, and if I find that I need to change the lights used in the recipe, I can just update the group and recook much faster. Oh, and unrelated, but does anyone else feel like this bottom section for recipes in the sequence sheet reminds them of the effects section in the sequence executor sheet back on grandMA 1? No? Just me? Okay. Next week, let's leave all of this recipe cooking behind and talk about something completely different. See you then.